5 Keys to Financial Freedom. My name is Richard Quek, and I'm from the sunny country of Malaysia. I'm a chartered accountant by profession and have been involved with internet marketing for the past 10 years. I'm author of more than 10 books on the subject of internet marketing, network marketing, and motivation. Why this particular topic is important? It is a fact that many people are stressed out because of the lack of money. 96% of the people are kept awake at night because of financial pressure. Many family problems are caused because of this issue. The world is facing the economic crisis and it will affect every one of us. The first key is you need to handle frustration. In life, things do not always turn out as you expect. There are unforeseeable obstacles and challenges that we have to go through. The best way to go about it is to treat these obstacles and challenges not as failure, result, but as outcomes. An outcome is good if it is what we desire. On the other hand, it could be what we do not desire. In this case, we need to learn from them and change. Remember that in every failure, there is an equivalent seed of success. Treat these outcomes as a learning experience. Know that the universe is teaching you something from every experience. Key number two, you need to learn how to handle rejection. The most feared word is no. No can deprive many of us of our desires and dreams. Realize that it is only a word and will not kill us. In fact, it will make us stronger. All successful men and women had to face many rejections and failures before they finally achieved success. Colonel Sanders had to go through 1,008 no's before he got his first yes. However, the one yes turned Kentucky Fried Chicken into a worldwide success. To overcome the fear of rejection, you can set negative goals. For example, this month I'm going to set a goal to receive 50 no's. When you receive 5 no's, you still have 45 no's to go to. At the end of 50 no's, I'm sure you will have a handful of yeses. Key number 3, learn how to handle financial pressure. This issue keeps 96% of the people awake at night. Some even go to the extent of ending their life by committing suicide. Here is my personal story. More than 10 years ago, I had more than Malaysian ringgit 1 million, about US dollar $320,000 outstanding debts. This is due to my loss in the stock market. Initially, I was not able to focus on my work because of stress and worry. I would go home during the afternoon to try to sleep, but I just kept on thinking about the problem and get more worried and stressed. Then one day, I thought to myself that the worst thing that can happen to me in Malaysia is to be declared a bankrupt. Being a bankrupt is not as bad as one imagines. You still have your loving family and can still have the opportunity to earn the money to discharge the bankruptcy. I contacted the financial institutions that I owed money to and negotiated with them on a repayment scheme. From that day onwards, I was no longer worried. I worked hard when I found the right opportunity, and I'm glad to say that today I have repaid every single cent back to my creditors. Here is one of the stories that I wrote in one of my books. Do not worry. There was a man who was unable to sleep because he was deep in thoughts and was worried about tomorrow's events. The wife, sensing his worry, asked him the reason why he was worried and was unable to sleep. He said, "Tomorrow our house payment is due and we have insufficient funds in our bank account. I'm worried what the bank manager will do. Will he recall our loan or will he resort to legal action? Maybe he may allow us to delay our payment." The wife thought for a while and said, "Isn't the bank manager the one staying on the opposite side of our house?" "Yes," the husband replied. The wife took the telephone and immediately called the bank manager saying, "We are your bank customer and we have a housing loan with you. Our monthly payment is due tomorrow, but we don't have sufficient funds to cover it. Good night." She put down the phone and said to the husband, I've told the bank manager that we are not able to make the house payment tomorrow. Let him do the worrying. Now you can go to sleep. Success principles. In most cases, we tend to major on minors. We tend to worry unnecessarily and do our own predictions of the outcome of situations we may be facing. Remain cool and face the problems when it arises, but do not ignore it totally, because it may grow and eventually catch up with you. Do not sweat the small stuff, because they are merely small stuff which can be solved or managed. In life, we need to be aggressive and not defensive. For example, if your income drops, most people will sell off their car and buy a smaller and cheaper car. They will probably move to a smaller house. There is nothing wrong with this, but you are being defensive. We should be aggressive and look for ways to earn more income to improve our standard of living. We should also work harder. When you are in an adverse financial situation, ask yourself this life-changing question. What is the worst thing that can happen to you? Key number 4. Learn how to handle complacency. This is indeed a silent killer, and many people are living their life this way. Here is another story from my book, How to Boil a Bullfrog. Years ago, some scientists did a simple experiment on a bullfrog. They threw a bullfrog into a container of boiling water, and the bullfrog instantly popped out of the boiling water. Next, they put the bullfrog into a container of cold water. The bullfrog liked it and stayed in the container. The scientists then turned on the heat at the bottom of the container. As the water got warmer, the bullfrog relaxed and took a nap. The bullfrog was so comfortable that it stayed in the container and was cooked. Success principles. Most of us are in the comfort zone. We have a house to go home to, a nice bed to sleep on, food in the fridge, a group of friends to mingle with, along with some basic necessities of life. We have worked hard to get to where we are now, so why should we change this? The truth is, most of us are like the bullfrog. Because we feel warm and comfortable, we refuse to get out of our comfort zone and prefer to stay where we are. In life, we are either creating or disintegrating. There is no such thing as staying where we are, because there is always movement. So if we are not moving ahead in life, we must by nature be moving in the opposite direction. There is no such thing as it is. We are either creating or disintegrating. If we are not moving ahead by default, we are moving the other direction. I do not know how well or badly you are doing financially at the moment, but one thing is for sure. I believe that you can do better. I strongly believe that things can change for the better in the next 12 to 24 months. You must have a strong desire to change. You must always strive to be better for your family and the community as a whole. Key number 5, be a giver. This is one of the most profound principles of wealth and success. A giving heart shows that you have more than enough. To be successful, we must develop the abundance mindset as opposed to the scarcity mindset. Giving is telling the universe that you have an abundant mindset. A scarcity mindset is one where we think that there is not enough of wealth and resources around, and we have to compete for them. When we have this mindset, you will be in a competitive plane and will be in a low state of vibration. Nothing good will come out of this low vibration. Be a giver. Give your time, money, love, compliments, and smile. When you give more, more will be given unto you. In the Bible, God states that, "Give freely and test me if I will not multiply what you have brought into the storehouse." When you give, it also shows that you are grateful for what you presently have and you feel good and joyful. Here is a bonus key number 6. Have fun. Stress is one of the causes of most health problems like cancer and cardiovascular problems. When we are stressed, the rate of vibration is very low, and this causes more negative situations to be attracted into our life. On the other hand, fun and joy carries high rate of vibration. When you are feeling good, your body produces hormones like endorphins, serotonin, and melatonin that makes your body healthier. When you have fun and feel good, you will attract good things and circumstances into your life. According to the law of attraction, what you think about, you bring about. So have fun and think about good things and start attracting good things into your life. So to summarize today's topic, here are the key points to financial freedom. Handle frustration. Handle rejection. Handle financial pressure. Handle complacency. Be a giver. And finally, have fun. So what now? Fill in your details below to get the transcript of the video in PDF format. You will also be receiving a few free ebooks that will be useful to assist you to have a positive mindset. Make these 6 keys a part of your life, and I will surely see you at the top. Thanks for listening. I wish you well and have a great day.